In this video, I'm going to discuss the advantages of filing a consolidated tax return. So the first advantage is that losses of one company are going to offset the taxable income of another company in the same consolidated group. So let's say you have Corporation A, you have Corporation B. Corporation A has $80 million of taxable income. And you say, hey, I'm going to have to pay tax on this. But Company B happens to have an $80 million loss. Okay, so in this case, if we are filing a consolidated tax return and they're both part of the same affiliated group, then this is going to cancel out this and you end up with zero taxable income. So the company's not going to have to pay any tax. So that's a major advantage of filing a consolidated tax return. Now, there are limitations in terms of taking losses of one of the other members of the affiliated group. So in terms of these net operating losses, if B, for example, so in this example, I said B had an $80 million loss this year and A had an $80 million taxable income. But what if another company, C, came in and adjoined the affiliated group and C had prior losses, okay, from back when it was by itself filing its own return and it had $50 million in prior losses. So these are from previous years before it became part of this consolidated group. So any prior losses, basically, long story short, Corporation C or this entire affiliated group will only be able to deduct these losses and apply these losses to the extent that C generates taxable income. Okay, so I'm going to make an entire video on this. Okay, so this is called the separate return limitation year rule or SRLY rule. Okay, and actually there's another limitation potentially too, Section 382, which if there's an ownership change of more than 50 percentage points. But in any event, I'm going to make videos on each of these. So right now I just want to let you know, in some cases the amount of net operating losses can be limited. All right, so advantage number two, consolidated return. So it makes it easier to bypass certain limitations, particularly when it comes to like deductions, for example. So I'm going to give you an example with charitable deductions. One company has $25,000 charitable deduction and has $100,000 of taxable income. The other corporation, so they're both part of a consolidated entity, they're both part of an affiliated group, and the other corporation doesn't donate any money and has $150,000 of taxable income. Now, at the time that I'm making this video, there is a rule that a corporation cannot deduct can't take a tax deduction for more than 10% of its taxable income related to charitable deductions. What does that mean? Well, if they filed separately here, Corporation A and Corporation B, Corporation A would be limited. They only get a $10,000 deduction here for this charitable deduction. Okay? But, so that's because it's $10,000 of $100,000, okay, so the limit would kick in. But if they were to file a consolidated return, then their taxable income would be combined. Okay, so they have $250,000 in taxable income, and 10% of that, 10% of that is $25,000. So guess what? Corporation A, basically, that $25,000 deduction for charitable donation would not be it wouldn't be limited to just $10,000. So that's just one example. There are other examples that we could go through, but just you see when you combine it, it's like, okay, it makes it easier to get around this limitation. Now, a third advantage of filing a consolidated return is when you have an intercompany transaction. So let's say we got Corporation A, we got Corporation B, and let's say a Corporation A, let's say it has land with a basis of $100,000. Okay, so $100,000, and it sells the land to Corporation B, let's say for $150K. Okay, $150K. All right, so normally you think, oh, well, there'd be a $50,000 gain, $150 minus $100. Okay, so then you'd say, okay, well, we're going to incur some tax liability here. But when it's a consolidated return, so when these are part of an affiliated group and they've elected to file a consolidated tax return, that gain is not going to be recognized. Okay, we're not going to recognize. Now, if B, so then B then took the property and then sold it to an outsider for, let's say, later they sell for $175,000. Okay, to an outside, and when I say an outsider, I mean someone that's not part of the affiliated group, like some unrelated party. Then in that case, okay, once it's sold to an unrelated party, then the entire gain, so this case it would be the difference between the basis and the 175, so then you'd have a $75,000 gain. But basically, when it's a consolidated tax return, it's like they're treating this all as one taxpayer. So you're not going to recognize any gain when there's a sale of property from one of the members of the group to another. So that's an advantage because that defers when you have to pay tax on that gain. Now, also, dividends. So like if A were to like issue a dividend to B, it's not going to be taxed. It's eliminated. Now, in terms of the parent, so remember, for you to have an affiliated group and file a consolidated tax return, you always need one identifiable parent. That's one of the requirements. I talk about that in my video on the requirements for filing a consolidated tax return. So let's say we've got a parent, and we've got we've got A, and then we've got B. Okay? And let's say that A paid $1 million. So $1 million to get the stock of B. So then A has a $1 million basis in B stock. Okay, so $1 million basis in B stock. Okay, so B is the subsidiary of A. Okay, now, if B then were to report, let's say $200,000 of income, if they were to report $200,000 of income, that is gonna increase A's basis in B stock. So then the basis would become 1.2 million. That's A's basis in B stock. It has gone up because now B has generated some income. Now you might say, well, how is this a tax advantage? How does this help A here? Well, if A were later to sell B stock, let's say they sell it later for, let's say, $1.5 million, then now because the basis is higher, you're going to have $1.5 million minus $1.2 million. You're going to have a $300,000 taxable gain. If A were to sell all of B stock, it'd have a $300,000 gain. If this had not increased the basis, if the basis had remained unchanged, then it would be a $500,000 taxable gain. So basically, that's why it's an advantage when the subsidiary generates income, it's going to increase the parent's basis in the subsidiary stock.